In this screencast, we're going to be talking about energy balances. So energy balances are similar to material balances since both mass and energy are conserved. In fact, if you take a look at the first law of thermodynamics, it states that energy can be neither created or destroyed. Probably the best way to state this is that the accumulation is equal to the input minus the output. Note there are no generation or consumption terms because, again, energy can be neither generated or created nor destroyed or consumed. So let's take a look at the three types of energy of the system. So these are kinetic energy, potential energy, and internal energy. So let's see what these are comprised of. So kinetic energy is the energy of motion, and this is equal to 1/2 times the mass or the mass flow rate times the velocity of the system squared. And sometimes instead of a V, you'll see a U instead. Potential energy is the energy caused by a change in elevation, and this is equal to M times G, which is the gravitational constant, times Z, which is the height of the object or fluid above the reference type. So the third type of energy that we look at is what's known as internal energy. And what it is it is due to molecular interactions. And what we mean by molecular interactions are the motion of the molecules. So this can be translational, rotational, electromagnetic, etc. In addition, we have Q, which is heat, and W, which is work. So Q, which is heat, is energy that is transferred via a temperature difference. For work, it's described as a response to any other driving force except for temperature. And where you'll usually see work is in something with moving parts, or such as a pump or a turbine or something like that. So let's start by looking at Q. And so this temperature difference is between the system and the surroundings. And so what that means is that Q crosses the boundary between the system and the surroundings. So let's say you have a reactor and the air around it is 25 degrees C, and a reaction takes place, then the products of the system is at 500 degrees C. So since there is a temperature difference between the system and the surroundings, is that heat will flow from the system, because it's at 500 degrees, to the surroundings. So Q is considered positive if heat is transferred from the surroundings to the system. So in this case, is Q negative or positive? So let's take a look. The system is at 500 degrees. The surroundings is at 25 degrees C. It's transferred from the system to the surroundings. Therefore, our Q is going to be negative. Now let's take a look at work. So how do we determine the sign of work? So work is positive if it's being done by the surroundings on the system. And one way to think of this rather than just mathematically. If we write our energy balance and we're going to assume that there is no potential energy and there is no kinetic energy, and we say that Q plus W is equal to the change in internal energy, if you think about it, if you transfer heat from the surroundings to the system, you're going to increase that internal energy. If work is being done by the surroundings on the system, you're going to increase that internal energy. So we're going to use these definitions to determine the amount of all these particular energies in different problems.